hello guys, and welcome to Turbo Racing for another stream. Tonight we are going to UKGTL and the NoGrip Legacy to drive the Christmas party race, of course. And as you can see, so far we are 10 people on the server, but we are waiting for more drivers to join. So it's going to be one absolutely amazing race, guys. I can promise you that, because this circuit, 1970 Spa-Francorchamps, is going to be so interesting and so tough, because we must drive at 100% throttle almost at the entire length of the circuit. So this means even the smallest mistake here on the acceleration means you are going to lose at least a few tenths of the second. And we have so much places where we can actually make a wrong acceleration. So basically the most important thing in this race, if you ask me, is going to be the consistency. Yes, of course, the pure speed and pace is going to be important, but you must be very consistent if you want to win this race. And guys, before the start of the qualifying session, around 4 minutes from now, I'm just gonna show you the setup I made for this event. Let me just take off the camera for a moment so you can see all of the settings. And this is our setup. And this time I had to make a little bit more laps to find the right setup for the car, because as I told you, this circuit is very different from the other circuits. And I had to make at least 40 laps to find out the right balance for the car. And the time I made with the full tank was 3:55.4, but I think I was able to drive even faster. And I made a big mistake at the end of this lap, so basically I think I lost around 7 tenths of the second. So maybe our pace with full tank here is going to be around 3:54.7.8, something like that. But because we will need at least 2 pit stop here, guys, I'm going to drive with less fuel and 3 stints. But this will be for later when the race will start. I'm planning to make 3 stints with 77 liters every stint. And for the qualifying session, because we will have just one attempt, one hot lap here on the qualifying session, I'm going with just 23 liters. And Rogak has entered with his Opel Commodore 2800. And guys, the other cars on the server are going to be Chevrolet Camaro SS, and the car we are going to drive, BMW 2800 CS. And I totally forgot to turn on the camera once again. Here I am, guys. Sorry about that. Yes, we are now waiting for the start of the qualifying session. As I told you, 15 minutes long and just one attempt of a hot lap. And the race is going to be 36 laps, or around 2.4 hours long. And guys, please tell me in the chat if everything is okay or something must be changed before the race, because when the race starts, there won't be time for changes. I hope everything is actually okay. Let me see the stream. I think yes, everything is going okay. My voice looks okay. So we are now just waiting for the start of the quali, and let's see what is happening on the server. And unfortunately Jeffers has some problems with his car. Of course, Jeffers, one of the favorites for the win here. And Das is entering the server as well, one of the fastest guys here, Das, with Alfa Romeo GTAm. So actually My mistake, guys, we are going to have 4 cars on grid. Opel Commodore, BMW, Alfa Romeo and the Chevrolet Corvette. We were able to have 5th car on the grid. I think it was 4th Escort or something like that, if I'm not mistaken. But unfortunately the car had some bugs and Jeffers is now on the server. And the car has some problems and Tony, the UKGTL moderator, had to take off the car from this race. So we are going to have 4 cars. And unfortunately Jeffers had to drive with the BMW, our car, to be our teammate. But from what I can see, he's driving with Alfa Romeo. Hope everything is going to be... I hope he will be able to drive, because with Jeffers is going to be much more interesting on the circuit. And we wait for 2 more drivers, because the grid was 15 places, so we are missing just 2 drivers. Unfortunately I can't tell you who they are. And now someone else. Oh, unfortunately Jeffers has decided to retire. This is something very, very not cool. Maybe he can still reinstall his mod. And we are now 11 people waiting for some more drivers. Jeffers, one of the most consistent drivers. This is going to be big loss for this race, but there are plenty of great drivers in the grid still. And I really hope 3 more drivers are going to join the race so we can have full grid. And I'm talking too much, guys. Let's just watch Zil from for a while with his BMW, our teammate. He's now at the beginning of the circuit. Of course, Zil takes our favorite number 3. We are going to drive with number 11 here. And Zil has a little bit of sliding, which is totally normal for this circuit, because if we don't count the big straights, we have some very, very tight and tough corners. So you need a little bit oversteer to take them a little bit quicker. As you can see, full throttle here from Zil, and after this very, very long corner, he is heading to one of the chicanes here, which is very, very tough. And 2 more drivers has joined. Actually, this is maybe Coyote and Tony, so we are now 13 drivers. And if we don't count Jeff, we need 1 more player to join, so we can have a full grid. I hope, guys, everything is okay with the stream. I count on you to tell me if there are some problems, but from what I can see from my laptop here, I think all is good. Yes, we are still riding with the Zil. Let's see if everything is... I hope Jeff will somehow be able to join the race. And yes, Dan is the only driver missing. I hope he's going to join us. Yes, we are now really just few moments away from the start of the qualifying session. Because of the problems, we will start qualifying just a little bit later. Meanwhile, Zil is leading the field with a 353.8 second position for Matt, 354.5, and third position for Quive, 355.2. Down to first gear here for the last corner. And let's see his final lap time. Is he going to be faster? 353.8 is his previous best. And yes, 353.4. This is a very, very fast from Zio. With the BMW 2800 CS. And I think the qualifying session will begin when Dan will enter the server. So let's stay with the Zil for another lap. Maybe we can change the camera. While we are waiting, guys, I'm going to practice a little bit with our Beamer. Let's see if everything is okay with the frames. I think yes. Going up the hill here at 4th gear, more than 200 km per hour, and we are now breaking 3rd for this hairpin. Of course we need the most pace here, so we can accelerate properly for the next long corners and fast corners. We are now approaching one of the dangerous chicanes, down to 3rd, and we need now the best possible acceleration here, because we have one more very, very long straight. And I think the qualifying session is going to be delayed to 19:30 GMT, guys, so apologies about that, but I think this is not a problem because we can still prepare our car. And now we are approaching the most difficult corner I had in this circuit, guys. This is very, very tough corner. Take a look. it's tough because you need to stay very, very fast at the apex, but not too fast because you can easily miss the car just like that. It's very, very tricky. So at the race and of course at the qualifying session, we must be really, really careful with this corner. Hope the car is not too damaged. Oh, wrong gear here, going up the hill. Totally missing the car. Fortunately, this driver was able to avoid us. We're approaching the end of the lap. One more very tricky corner here. Now let's try to focus. Meanwhile, Coyote is taking the lead, 53.2. I really don't think we can fight with that pace, but who knows. At least not in the qualifying session, but at the race everything can happen. The race is going to be really long. Exit from this chicane. Oh, just clipping the wall there. Okay, let's see our new fastest lap. 55.0, it's not too good, I think. Wow, Coyote is so fast, guys. 52.7. And here is Dan, guys. Dan is now on the server, so maybe we can start the qualifying session soon. Just going right there. This is how easy you can ruin your lap. But the good news is we can go a little bit faster than 55.0. Totally messed up. And we have a full grid now, guys. Unfortunately, without Jeffers because of some technical issues. So I really hope we can start soon. Matti said the car just ahead of us. Maybe we can match this lap, 54.5, but I don't know how much fuel Matti use for this lap. Maybe I can take off some more fuel for the qualifying session. Yes, maybe with the 17 liters is going to be better. And we have just 9 more minutes to the qualifying session, guys. Yes, indeed, we must be very, very careful. We don't want to ruin our race early on, at the start of the race, of course, so we must be very, very careful. But let's ride with Coyote for a while. He's the fastest car so far. 52.7 is something absolutely amazing from him. Which car is he driving? Opel Commodore 2800. And maybe we can go like that. Yes, there he is. Some jokes about the about my age, that I'm maybe the younger driver on the field right now. So let's go back to Coyote, of course. Yes, guys, we are now just 6 more minutes to the start of the qualifying session. We are so close, and the quali is going to be just 15 minutes, so we are close to the race as well, to the main event. Let's see if we can learn something from Coyote's driving, as he is so fast. He is very careful here. Don't have any oversteer at all. His car is great and balanced. I think this is the place where we lost so much pace, actually. His car is so much balanced than our car. we have just a little bit more oversteer though, but I'm starting to worry about what I'm seeing from Coyote. He is very, very fast. And I'm not sure we can fight with him, but as I told you guys, everything can happen here. 2.4 hours. This is an endurance race. Oh, just a small mistake here and he's gonna lose at least 1 second. This is what I told you guys, the smallest mistake and you lose at least a few tenths. Just like that. He's trying pit stops. So let's take a look at the Zio and at the chat. And we are indeed alive, so Fulvio must be careful about what he is going to say. And we are now 21-28 here in Bulgaria, so we are now 2 minutes away from the start of the qualifying session. This is our teammate Zil with a BMW 28. Oh, so much sliding here. Maybe this is one of the differences between the car Coyote is driving, Opel Commodore, and our BMW. The Commodore is a little bit more precise, a little bit more balanced, but our BMW has a little bit more oversteer. This may result in more tire wear though, so we must be very careful. And based on my calculations, guys, we will need at least one tire change. But I don't know when this is going to happen, at the first pit stop or maybe in the second one. I think it's better to be at the first, but who knows, we are going to lose so much time changing tires, or maybe we can stick with the original tires, but this will mean we are going to be very, very slow at the end of the race, and our car is going to be more dangerous to drive. So what I'm going to do is I'm just gonna drive at least 10-15 laps in the first stint, and I'm gonna decide if I'm going to change the tires or stick with the original ones. I think this is the best idea. And here we are. We are now voting for the start of the qualifying session. Thank you, Heidsen. All the best to you, mate. And I hope to see you more in the 2021 at Altbierbude and, of course, at Festbierbude as well, driving GTR2 Power and Glory mod. I know you like this mod, especially the Porsche cars we drove at Jerez. It was such a great battle with you there. And here we are, guys. The quarry has begun. I'm just gonna wait a little bit more because we have 15 minutes, so let's ride for a while with Coyote. once again, this Opel Commodore is so, so balanced. This will be great for his tires, I believe. But maybe his the fact that he's going to be faster will mean he will need more fuel on board. So maybe maybe he's going with free pit stops. Who knows? It will be very interesting. But I think most of us are going to stick with just two pit stops. But some of the cars has less fuel, so. Who knows, maybe some of them will change to free pit stops. As you can see, more of the drivers are now already on the circuit. I'm just gonna wait until 10 minutes left and I'm gonna start my qualifying hot formation lap, and after that, of course, the one hot lap we are eligible to do. Hello, Gonshtik, всем привет! Maybe you are from Russia. Welcome to the channel, and if you like what you are seeing on the screen, don't forget to hit the like button, of course. And subscribe for Turbo Racing for more future sim racing in the next months and years, I hope. And I'm gonna answer to you after the race. There are few websites where we are driving GT Legends, and you can actually wrote them on the Google. Out Beer Bude is one of the leagues, and UKGTL is the other league. Just spell UKGTL on Google and you can find this actually league where we are driving right now. Oh, thank you for the sub. I'm gonna answer you after the race. Because I think YouTube won't let me to put links on the chat. And Coyote is now starting his first and only lap on the qualifying session. Take a look at his driving just a little bit more, and we can start driving as well. And yes, this is one of the leagues Heidsen is talking about, www.outbeerbude.d. There you can find hundreds of cars and trucks for free and legal. And guys, I think now we are ready to start driving. The reason I waited a little bit was that I just want to have some time to compare my driving with. Yes, just use the link Heidsen has provided. www.outbeer.b. You can find all the necessary links there. And as well simracing.org.uk for this league I'm driving at the moment. Oh, this is great that you are in the car now. Are you gonna participate there? Yes, I'm using the Steam version of the game, version 1.1. Coyote with the free 52.2 and Zeal with the free 52.6. They are really really quick and there is no chance I can fight with them on the qualifying session, but my hope is that our car is going to be better with more fuel. This was a great exit from the corner. We get some great acceleration now for the long straight. Okay, let's see our lap time now. Let's hope for at least 54. Yes, 54.5. It's not the best, but at least we are in P5. For us now. Thanks, guys. Thanks. I'm gonna give my best. Ganshtik, contact me on Discord if you have additional questions how to join. I'm gonna put some links there as well and I'm gonna help you. And how many cars we have on the road? Just Fulvio. Fulvio left and one more minute, but unfortunately I don't think Fulvio will have... Yes, he has made his lap so far. So guys, we are going to start from P5. Pole position for Coyote 3:52.2. Second position for Zil 52.6. Third position for Miha 54.2. And from third to fifth position, just 3/10 of the second. This is going to be so interesting. The battle for the podium at least. And Quaif is just 2/10 of the second behind me as well. So the battle for the podium is open here, I think. And unfortunately, does he had some problems with his sound, so he's gonna start from P13. But he was one of the fastest cars as well. I think he was in P2 before leaving the server. And guys, let me put some fuel. I was about to forget about that. And let me just see. I think 77 liters are going to be okay. Let me just write it here. So I won't forget about how many liters I need to put on in the pit stop. And we are now just 30 more seconds before the start of the race. Guys, I hope you are ready because this marathon is about to start in about a moment. Of course, good luck to all of the drivers. Yes, the game is absolutely legendary. Add me on Discord and I'm gonna message you after the race. I'm really happy that you like this legendary, in my opinion, game as well. I totally love GT Legends, guys, and GTR2 as well. Simbin's greatest creations, I think. Even though I think they are actually producing a race room, but I'm not absolutely sure about that. But GT Legends and GTR 2 for sure. And here we are, guys, on the race session. Now it's time to concentrate. The frames are actually okay. Oh, what the hell? What the hell? Why stop and go penalty? I really don't know what the hell happened there. I hope there is going to be restart, because I really don't know what the hell happened. It's totally not fair. And something is happening with the shadows as well. I don't know what happened, Christo. I think everything was actually okay. I didn't started driving before the lights out. But I'm gonna continue driving, of course. It's going to be long race. I'll be very curious to see the replay though. Okay guys, I'm going for the stop and go. are going to lose so much time, at least 30 seconds, I think. But we're still in the game. Meanwhile, Coyote is leading, followed by Zeal. And a fantastic start from Das. He started from P13 and he is now in P2. This is what I call fantastic start. I don't know, maybe it has. At least the car has a speed limiter, so I believe all of the drivers are going to apply the speed limiter. Just 10 seconds behind Tony, our first arrival, and unfortunately I can see that someone is missing. We are 13 drivers. Yeah, absolutely no point risking. I don't want the new stop and go penalty. But this is a great question from you, Christo. No one knows the answer though. Unfortunately. Oh, something happened with Ave here. So the mistakes are starting to happen. Fair play from him. Maybe he has some damage. By the way guys, I think I have found some great rhythm now. I'm not pushing too hard because we don't want any more mistakes. Just need to drive consistent. And a mistake from Miss Noemis. Mike. So we are up to P11. Just 7 seconds behind Tony and Dan. A little bit wider there on Orush. I think I could have done it better. Wow, Ave is driving with my pace. Maybe. The slipstream is helping him, or maybe we are just too slow, I don't know. We almost caught Tony. Zero is actually okay, but I believe I can go even faster. But I just don't want to risk. This corner, Christo? Oh. Nah. Just a little bit oversteer there and I messed up the corner. Or maybe I entered the corner too early. It's very tough to read and drive here because yes, we have straights but with some corners, so the main problem in this corner is the fourth gear. But I can do absolutely nothing because I can change only final gear of this car, and I'm on the highest final gear, so I really can't do absolutely nothing about fourth gear. It's too long. We have some slipstream now. We are closing Tony. Maybe we can start some fight, but helping each other with the slipstream to try and catch Dan just in front of us. Unfortunately, I don't know what Tony thinks about that. Oh, Tony's going to the pit really early on. Oh no, he's actually letting us pass. So no playing together. Okay, 6.5 seconds behind the Dan. At least we are now on top 10. This is better now. Yeah, but I'm afraid to go wide there, Christo, because it's really easy to lose the car there. The corner just sucks you in, and there is nothing you can do. It's very dangerous. No. Oh, cut track, my god. This is too slow. I can feel the tires are worse now, even though they look like a new one, but I'm losing some grip. And Micha is on the pits. Something happened with him. Oh, actually Zio as well. Or actually it's just Zio. So maybe Zio is going with more pit stops. No, it's Zio and Tony. Or maybe Zio just wanted to be fast on the first stint and put some less fuel on board. But these guys are so fast. I really don't know why I'm so slow today. But as I told you guys, I had some problems setting up the car. So maybe I just don't know how to set up a BMW 2800. But still plenty of racing to go. So we are not gonna give up, of course. This is better. Trying to keep pace in the apex. Thank you. Somehow Micha just 10 seconds ahead of us, so we still have plenty of opportunities. And of course at the end of the race some of the drivers are going to be tired, and everything can happen. Meanwhile I must stay focused because I don't want to miss my pit stop. We have I think 6 more laps. Yes. So at the end of lap number 13 we are going for pit stop number 1. And guys, meanwhile, you can expect a great update on Turbo Racing, my YouTube channel, in the coming few weeks. I'm working on something really big, but I'm not gonna spoil anything. I'm working on something that will help me improve the channel. Produce better content. So guys, if you are new here, don't forget to hit the like button and of course subscribe to Turbo Racing for more future great sim racing. As we're just faster than Dan, 6.2 seconds now, but overall he has our pace. So basically we just need to be a little bit more consistent than him. Just white. Fortunately we didn't waste so much time. Maybe a few tenths. Now the tires are just not in great shape, especially front left is in really bad condition. So guys, we must change the tires at least once. It will be very dangerous to keep driving that way. Yeah, it's a wonk. But as I told you, nothing I can do about 4th gear. It's the way it is. only final gear can be changed, and I'm driving on the higher final gear, so yes, I can drive less higher gear, but we are going to lose pace on the straights. This front left. Maybe I can change only the front tires. That way the pit stop is going to be a little bit shorter, but I don't know. Maybe that way I'm gonna have problems on acceleration. I tried that way. I tried this maneuver on Kjosbjergude, changing only the front tires, and I had so much trouble on acceleration after that. Yes, maybe we can try something different, because we are definitely slow tonight. Thank you. grip at all. Guys, three more laps before our first pit stop. First pit stop if we don't count the stop and go penalty, of course. Meanwhile, Das is leading and fighting with Coyote for the first position, third position for Quive so far. We are trying to catch somehow Dan and Micha, but they both have our pace. Some problems for Mike. Us on the pits. So guys, I'm gonna change just the front tires. This will be our strategy. This is great. Exit from the corner. And we are just 3/10 of a second slower than our personal best. Made with the new tires, of course. But we are still 7.5 seconds behind the Dan. And 11 seconds behind Miha. Amazing lap, guys, amazing lap. Maybe new personal fastest lap of the race, yes, new personal. And just before the pit stop. So maybe the tires are not so bad. But we need to change them. They won't last until the end of the race. The race leader is going to repeat as well. Oh my god. Yes. We need some fuel. Meanwhile, Rogak also on the pit. Now just the tires. Unfortunately, we are going behind Fulvio, but we are somehow in front of Zeal, so maybe some damage for him. And Das is behind us, which is very strange. So P8 for us now. I have some oversteer, but maybe this is because the tires are still very cold. Yes, maybe it takes the same time, which is a shame. Oh. my god. It's so tough on Urush. We need a little bit more laps so the front skim takes some tar wear as well. So the tires are going to be more balanced after a few laps. It was a bad idea to change just the fronts, guys. The car is very unbalanced. Yes, maybe. Actually, after lap 26, I think. Because the HUD shows the lap we are into. So basically, we have made 14 laps. And we have fuel for 12 more. Oh my god, how I was able to keep the car running. This is beyond me, but it's becoming really hard to drive the car. I just need to change my driving because of the more oversteer. I just need to adapt. Yes, I think I found how to drive the car now. Just a little bit more gentle with the steering. And look at that lap, guys, we are so fast. Oh, we are going faster. Maybe the sliding can help me a little bit on the slower corners. Yes, the car is a little bit harder to drive, but as you can see, it's faster. Oh, no, no, no. Mika on the pits. Oh my god, I was looking at the laps to see which lap it is. lap 17. 9 laps until the second pit stop. Guys, we are just 30 seconds away from the podium. This is the stop and go penalty, I think. Wow, Micha is just 6 seconds behind us. Maybe he is with new cars. Guys, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit the like button, share the link with your friends, of course join the conversation, and if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe for future sim racing. And guys, I think 62 liters actually are going to be enough. Just to be sure, enough for 10 laps. If we are going to the pit at the end of lap 26, we'll have 10 laps to go, so 62 liters are going to be just fine. Meanwhile, we have a still great chase with Micha, as Zio and Das are chasing us as well. They are much faster than us. So maybe they are going to catch us before the end of the race, especially Zio. As unfortunately Tony has retired. So 10 cars are still on the server. Oh, something happened with Micha actually. I don't know. Oh no. Oh no no, my internet stopped. These things happen in sim racing, guys. I'm really sorry about that, but we must retire, unfortunately, because something happened. I don't know if it's with the stream, with the server, or is with my internet, guys, but unfortunately we must finish the race here at lap number 19. We were driving really well after that. I'm so sorry, guys. I really wanted to finish the race because we were gaining some positions after the stop and go penalty in the first lap, but it wasn't meant to be. Let's see the fastest lap. So yeah, we are really really slow. As you can see, 3.1 seconds slower than Coyote, which is too much. But we were in P7. Oh my god, now now the internet is back, I think, but I'm out of the game. And once again, definitely something is happening, guys, but I don't know if this is based on my internet or not. Maybe this is server related. I'm just gonna wait just a little bit more. Let me see if there is some information on the server, on the website. But unfortunately something broke, guys. And as I can see on the forum, a lot of guys are actually telling us that they have lost connection. Tony in lap 19 and Rogak on lap 20. So guys, this is actually something happening with the server. I'm gonna wait just a little bit more time because I'm hoping for restart, but I don't know if this is possible. We still have a lot of racing to go. I'm gonna just wait for Tony to see what we can do from here. Is a restart possible or we must retire? But as you can see, this is definitely internet connection disconnect. And I have a big history with retirements due to internet, mostly because of my internet, but this time the situation is a little bit different. This is something I can't remember happening in my sim racing career. Maybe in the early days while I was driving in Bulgaria and the internet was really bad at this years 2007-2008. Yes, but after that, after the internet became so much better, I really can't remember something like that. And thus has lost connection to the server as well. Guys, I really hope we can have restart. Oh no, Norbert, I didn't hit the black flag. I went to the pit to actually to serve my stop and go, and everything was okay after that. This is actually internet disconnection. This is not related to stop and go penalty. As you can see, the reason for retirement is DNF, do not finish. It's not the black flag or DQ. Very interesting situation. Once again guys, my apologies for what happened. We had great sim racing, yes, we didn't have battles, but we had such a great chases with Miha, with Dan at the beginning, with Tony, and we were actually gaining some positions with yes, we made a few little mistakes, but overall I was driving okay. And maybe we had a chance for top 7 finisher at the end. And based on what Das is saying on the forum, right now on the server there are just 4 drivers. Yes, the button is black because you cannot rejoin the session when the session is a race session. This is the reason. So this means when you retire from a race, you cannot rejoin the race, Norbert. And you can see how the cars are paused, actually. They are invincible, which means there is no connection with the server. I don't know what to say here, guys. I'm just gonna wait a few more minutes before a decision can be made. And I'm gonna show you what the decision is. I'm so sorry. Putting so much effort in the race. Putting so much effort in the race, and after that, this thing happened. Just after the middle of the race, actually. I really don't want to end the stream, guys. I want a decision that we can make a restart. But I'm actually really glad that the stream went really well. I think the quality was okay. The quality of the mic was okay. My driving was maybe okay, so the stream went really well, actually, and we had such a great chases while the race lasted. It was going to be very interesting between me and Miha, because Miha was just a little bit faster than me, but 4 or 5 seconds behind me, and it was not clear if some of us was going to change his tires. And there is no information, guys. I'm gonna end the stream. I'm really sorry for what happened, but I hope you enjoyed the content, because we had, as I told you, great chases. Unfortunately, I had stop and go penalty at the beginning and we lost so much time there. But if you enjoyed the content, don't forget to hit the like button, share the link with your friends, join the conversation in the comment section below. I'm gonna answer to all of you. And of course, if you are new here, subscribe to Turbo Racing for future sim racing. So guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Happy racing, everybody, and bye.